What's up, Aquarius? I'm going to try to do your video without having to do a pre-ramble shuffle, and all that other stuff that I did with the other ones. I've been a talkative person today, saying random things. So, anyway, Aquarius, this song is called I Love Me by Demi Lovato. I don't own the rights. I want y'all to stop beating up on yourself and start giving yourself some more self-love, okay? That's definitely big, big, big vibes on your reading already, okay? Stop trying to beat the Joneses or whatever the saying is, all right? Because you've been thinking way too negatively and you're gonna start manifesting bad things in your life if you don't stop that crap right now, sir or ma'am, Aquarius, or if you have Aquarius in your chart. Not all of this reading may resonate with you, so you might need to just, if it doesn't resonate, then go ahead and, you know, listen to one of my other ones or listen to them, the other signs, because it could be that, you know, it's something else that you're needing to hear today. So right now, I feel like you're not listening to your intuition about a partnership that is slow boogie. I mean, I feel like it's something that you've had for a while. It is like, you think it's stable, but it's really not. It's not really up to par. And there's a lot you're not talking about. The King of Swords just popped out. So I'm just doing a shuffle right now. You need to get out of a love situation that has you full of, being around a bunch of drama. I don't know what is the deal with the drama in these cards today, but we're going to shuffle some. I feel like we have a female energy that is being a little promiscuous. I don't know if it's your partner or if it's you, but I definitely sense that here, and I think you already know who it is, so I'll go ahead and leave it as is. Spirit just telling you already know who it is. All right, so anyway, Aquarius, let me see what Spirit wants to tell me from my Bible here for my Aquarians. Look, y'all, I don't know how y'all feel about this, but there's a little mojete right here with some coins in it. And I put it on my, that's grinding, you know, grinding, doing his work. Well, give me my coins, the feathers there, you know what I'm saying? Divinely guided, angel wings, whatever. Put that on there as a reminder here. That's where my wealth comes from, is from knowing what the promises are for me, right? Okay, so let's go ahead and get up in here. All right, guys, the lampstand and the two olive trees. Oh, ooh, I like this. Okay, guys, I asked the angel who talked with me, what are these, my Lord? He answered, do you not know what these are? No, my Lord, I replied. So he said to me, this is the word of the Lord. Not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord Almighty. Ooh-wee. Ooh, he's talking about the olive branches beside the two gold pipes. Dude. I mean, these are not olive branches, but are they olive branches? I don't know what olive branches look like, but them talking about, yeah, that's weird, a little bit. Okay, so he says, then I asked the angel, what are these two olive trees on the right and the left of the lampstand? Again, I asked him, what are these two olive branches beside the two gold pipes that pour out golden oil? All right. He said, these are the two who are anointed to serve the Lord of all of the earth. So, anyway, guys, there's a woman in a basket here. Alexa, play more like it.
Sure, here you go. I'm out here looking like a bitch.
Okay. Guys, this is what I'm going to say here. God just wants us to remember that it's only through His Spirit that we have anything that's everlasting or where value can actually be accomplished. Okay? You know, when you have God on your side and you live for God, you don't need to worry about trusting in your own strength or your own abilities, okay? You really need to just depend on God and work in the power of His Spirit. So I feel like if you have Aquarius in your chart, you're being asked or you're being told that you have an anointing. If you know that God has a calling on your life and you're not answering it, you know, you're going to have a lot of tower moments, because anything you try to build that goes against what the plan is of your life, you're going to have to hold on to it super tight. And you're going to feel like mentally so challenged, because you're going to feel stuck, like you're not growing, you can't grow. And the reason you can't grow is because the anointing that you have over you is not being permitted to. You're going to have blockages when you're not riding off into your purposes. He's not going to let you gain wealth like the normal person. God has a plan for your life, and you have to get your income the way He wants you to do it. So you have to, get like right in the middle of the thick of all your drama. You know what I'm saying? And you have to be okay with walking away from it. And you have to, like, you know, walk out of this situation knowing that God wants something better for you. You know, He wants you to have all of the sweet parts, you know, of life. And this experience on this planet right now is exactly what we need, because it helps us to see who the hurting people are and who the lost ones are. And I feel like with this, He's wanting you to pour out what you're learning. Let it, whatever you're getting downloaded, let it roll off of you onto other people around your life, okay? Because He wants to reveal a lot of things about people around you who don't have the best intentions for you, that you think are really part of your soul tribe, and they're not. They're far from it. They're just really good fakers. And you know, you'll have people who come in, oh, well, they give me this and they give me that, but there's what you give to them is way greater in value. And I say that because sometimes, you know, in the eyes of heaven, you can have people who will have $10 and they'll give you the whole $10, and then you'll have people who have $100,000 and won't even give you $10. The weight of what you're given is not based on a dollar amount, it's based off of energy. So if you're the type of person who gives every dollar you have to your home, like directly, every penny that goes in there, it can get tiring to feel like you can invest and invest, and then you end up burnt the hell out wondering why, you know, you're not able to build. It's like, you got somebody drilling a hole in the boat that you just bought. You know what I mean? Even if you didn't buy a boat, even if you can't afford a boat, even if you can't afford a fishing pole, you know what I'm saying? It's one of those things where it's all about your mental state. And I feel like I've been able to see a lot of stuff that God has for me, and I've been blessed to do that. But I think you need to be able to do that. And it's definitely time for you to tap in, because I feel like it's saying that you have a purpose up in this world, and it's not to be stressed out. Look, you have a purpose to nurture people in this world and help the world as a whole. That's your family, your jobs, the planet, everything. And you need to get out of your head with all this drama that you're always in, because you have a purpose. Get to it. All right, let's get to this reading already. Yeah, you need to break out of a partnership that's caused you to be in a lot of regret and pain, because it is currently your weakness, and it is not allowing your internal guidance to be in full manifestation mode. It is actually a situation where you really need to gain strength that you didn't have before, because once you step into this power, and I feel like you're already doing that, you're going to be having a lot more stability in your life, and I feel like you're even gonna have more romantic offers. You're gonna just be looking more like vivacious, if that's a word, vivacious. Anyway, I feel like, you know, you're going to be feeling sexy. You're going to be feeling light and breezy. And, you know, there is a little bit of an energy of feeling uncomfortable being single at this time. But you really need to go ahead and just roll with it, because it, when you do, it's putting you in. And I do see you doing that, because I see you in a future energy of taking a new risk on love, on a new endeavor. All of it is divinely guided and exactly what you need at this time in your life. So right now, Aquarius, you're coming off as the Queen of Cups. That could be you being very soft and nurturing. If you're a man, you could still be the Queen of Cups. You're harnessing more of your female energy, your softer side, and that is very attractive for a man to be able to be vulnerable, to be able to, you know, tap into that side. That definitely means that you're able to more so manifest in things of that nature. And I feel like right now you're waiting on something to happen. You're waiting on a love interest in particular. I feel like whatever it is, you've already had your eye on something, and you pretty much have locked in something in here already. I feel like you've already made a soul agreement with this person. Yeah. And it's kind of a fear that you feel like you've already locked in onto someone after being all through all this stuff that you were with in this breakup, where you thought you were with a soulmate and then you were super bummed. And now you're like, I don't even want to be bummed anymore. I want to gain my strength back and I want to go get back out there and enjoy being single and try again, you know? And I think that's a beautiful attitude to have, Aquarius. So if you are waiting on something to come in, I feel like don't wait, babe. Just do you, and it will definitely work out in your favor, okay? So get out of your head, because I feel like, you know, there's going to be a lot of bickering and chatter and gossip coming up that make you emotional and feel the need to feel guarded in your heart area. But don't let that happen, okay? You keep that heart chakra flowing. Keep the love going. Surround yourself by unicorns, some people who are your tribe family who can help you be more like you instead of like other people who you don't want to be like, you know? So if you were hurt in the past by someone not communicating stuff properly with you, maybe even got ghosted, and you know, maybe you got your heart broken, or maybe somebody just exiled you after you cheated on them and you were sorry but it just didn't work. There's a lot of different scenarios I'm seeing here with these cards. We could do a specific reading if you are interested in, you know, getting some details on any of this. Let me know. But in the meantime, thank you so much, my Aquarius loves. Have a blessed day. Hope y'all like this reading. Hit me up for your personals.